Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force. And today's mission at hand is Javelin. Now, I previously got confused, and just before I was recording this, I accidentally started off with the mission Spectre, and it wasn't until the end of the mission briefing that I realized that this is actually the mission that had been unlocked, and this was one of the two optional missions that we could have targeted for this campaign. But anyhow, it would seem that if things go the way they should, we should be able to just skip any one of these missions and just complete the Indonesia campaign without ever touching Javelin. So yeah, let's see what this mission is about. The mission is simple: infiltrate the terrorist base and destroy the radar and missile launcher. Okay, execution. Your insertion point is approximately 300 meters south of the terrorist base. Follow your checkpoints to position in the hills east of the base. From this position, you should have a clear view of the radar, designated objective bomber. Huh, I wonder why all the names are pretty, I don't know, Western, so to speak. And the launcher designated objective bomb. Once you are in position, wait for Alpha and Charlie team to divert attention away from the objectives, then move in and destroy them. Success of this mission depends on the destruction of both objectives. Expected enemy forces. A special reconnaissance team has observed the disposition of the terrorist forces at the base. They report a substantial enemy force of approximately 30 to 40 men. Yeah, I can take them on. I have previously. The majority of these men are on duty at positions throughout the base. However, perimeter patrols are heavy. Allied support. Alpha team and Charlie team will be inserted on the eastern and western flanks of the enemy base. Okay, one is somewhere over here. That is Alpha team on the eastern flank. Charlie team would probably be on the western flank. Okay, that's nice. So, yeah. They are tasked with securing the perimeter of the base in order to allow you unimpeded movement to your attack position. That is very good. So I will not hopefully be facing too much resistance from the base itself. If Alpha and Charlie team do their job properly without dying, I should have clear shots at the missile launcher and shouldn't be responsible for taking the entire base out single-handedly. But this is Delta Force, and we know that's probably not gonna happen. So yeah. Once both objectives are destroyed, Alpha and Charlie team will rendezvous with you at the extraction point. Situation. Documents captured during the neutralization of the IMT training base have led to the discovery of another IMT base south of the city of Palembang. Careful analysis of these documents has led J2 to the conclusion that IMT is attempting to modify several SA-2 Gecko missiles to carry biological warfare agents. If the modifications are finished, those missiles could threaten many neighboring countries. Destroying the missile launcher and flat phase radar system required to launch these missiles has been upgraded to the highest priority for Delta operations. Now, you see the situation here. So apparently this game has a feature where if a grenade explodes too close to your head, it makes you...
Bravo team, move into the camp. Alpha and Charlie secure
the
perimeter.
Deaf for a few seconds. Roger King 6, it makes you deaf for a few seconds. So anyway, let's just go ahead and follow the objective markers, because I'm curious about what that green thing is in the middle of the first base camp. There certainly is something there, and as soon as we cross this, mount, don't accidentally cross it, because as soon as you cross it, you'll basically be entering, you'll basically be in full view of this enemy encampment right here.
Alpha to Bravo, in position on the perimeter. We'll take up the rear.
Roger Alpha.
This is Alpha, moving north towards the objective.
Roger Alpha, Godspeed. I thought I saw somebody there. I guess not. Now, one of the things I find, puzzling about this game is how sometimes bullets can literally, you can literally get hit from when you're hiding behind entire mountains, but at the same time, it's difficult to hit hill-glitched enemies yourself. Sort of hypocritical if you ask me, but well, it is what it is, I suppose. I should not keep exposed like that while I'm looking at the map, because that is, I think, a surefire way to die. Lag, where is lag? This game has been lagging a lot for me, and I think it has something to do with the DG Voodoo. But of course, I cannot know for sure. I think those are dead people. More people approaching my location. Some more people around. I'm just gonna, you know, lie down here in peace. Try and use a peaceful approach. Oh, that was close. That was cutting it really close. Let me just go ahead and reload this grenade launcher. There are some more people around here who will try to come and assault me. And I probably should not hold this position. It's actually a bad strategy. There are some people trying to flank me from behind as well. Need to be careful about them. Like this person here. God, I've gone this stress off like that though. Let me just keep moving. I sort of made one of the, you know, most fatal mistakes of playing a tactical shooter, and I started playing it as an action shooter instead. So the thing is, you always want to keep on the move if you're gonna take on multiple enemies like this. And you want to make sure that the enemies, they don't get the drop on you. Now, I think one of my enemies is right here. Yeah, right, there you are. So, yeah, you sort of want to keep moving. You don't want to get caught up in their aggression. Let them, you know, keep presenting them with newer opportunities to target. I don't think there is a player there. Oh, there might be. Who knows? This guy seems closer. I'm just going to try and shoot him. And I did. There was somebody else shooting at me, but I'm not going to sit around and let them, you know, present them with a target to do that. What I'm going to do instead is climb up this hill and take out the enemy forces over here. Now, this is absolutely not how this game was, or at least this mission was meant to be played, because Bravo and Alpha do start their maneuvers in this mission. However, this being Delta Force, the enemy is far more competent than the allies, and you end up dying. Count yourself lucky to have only lost your legs and not your life. So yeah, Bravo and Alpha do start their maneuvers, however they do not, how do I put this? They are unsuccessful in providing a distraction, in that they die easily. There's another person right here. Yeah, there. There you are. Look at you, running away. Should be some people over here. I need to be careful at this position, because I can easily get shot down. I can hear somebody on the right. Not exactly the best of places for me to be hiding, to be honest. And I feel sort of under-equipped for this mission. Ah, somebody's shooting me all the way over from over on that hill. And they died. The bullet drop in this game is also pretty confusing. I mean, it's impressive that the game has bullet drop in the first place, but at the same time, the bullet drop is also pretty confusing, because So somebody is almost shooting me, and I want to make sure that they can't exactly do that, or at least can't keep doing that. So let me go ahead and rotate a little, present them with newer targets. Checkpoint Charlie, just gonna set it there. Now who's shooting at me? Probably people from the hill over there, right? That guy's dead. Also, I think, yeah, that guy's dead. Now who has the nerve to shoot at me? And from where? Is my question. Nobody down there, that I can see at least. There's somebody over there though. Ah, I see. I completely forgot to take you out, didn't I? Now who else is there? Ah, I see. You're another one of the threats that I was talking about. The one that disappeared behind the mountain initially. Is that the thing that is registering as a green thing? Like, is it supposed to be like a vehicle? Huh. I guess curiosity does kill the cat. Because I've literally died on this mission on multiple occasions. And have had nothing to show for it. Okay, I need to get a fresh angle on this guy, because I can't kill him otherwise. And I need to proceed with caution, like a little bit more amount of caution, because I'm down to like very few of my bullets. Not a lot of bullets left at this point for me. I thought there was a person behind this pillar here. I think there is, isn't there? Like there's a person glitched behind the pillar over there. I'm just gonna go ahead and blow that up so that it doesn't blow up in my face when I'm taking on this fight. I thought there was supposed to be a person in there. Apparently there isn't. And I wonder if I can drive any of these cars. Of course, I would not try too hard to do so, because that would be a pretty large, error if the game bugs out after having accomplished so much. Which is practically nothing at this point, but yeah. I mean, we are so quite far away from accomplishing any of our objectives. Okay, what about anybody in here? Is there anybody in there? I think there should be two more people in there, right? I can hear somebody to my left firing shots at me. Yeah, there is somebody behind that tower. Thought as much. Anyway, let me just go ahead and ignore those people for a while. Even though it's like a very risky play. But these guys are docile for the most part. And yeah, these should be enough rounds to take care of this person. Are you dead, sir? Yes, good sir, you are dead. Okay, just one more person over here, and I do not think it was referring to that car, actually. I think there's something else in there that we can use. Now, I am looking right towards this person, and that person is looking right towards me. I would like to just keep a little bit of gap between, you know, myself and...
Charlie, target is north of the base. North of the base.
Now, is that because I...
Take out both targets. Repeat, take out both targets.
Roger.
Oh, doctor, so long.
Did this guy just say doctor so long? Anyway, let me just go inside this base and see if any of these people are... Huh. There's a dead guy. There's a dead guy. But for whatever reason, it shows me that there is a green person inside this place, and I don't know what that green person is, honestly. Ouch, I should not have reloaded there. But anyway, mistakes were made. Oh, look at them. Even my friends are proceeding towards the objective. And I think this should make the job much easier for them as well. At least as easy as it makes the job. As easy as it becomes for me at this point, at the very least. So. Now, there are some people who are shooting at me with the intention to kill. I would rather be a little cautious in approaching them. Not a lot of people here that wish me ill, as far as the eye can see. One of you is dead. Oh, that's the other person.
King 6, this is Alpha! Resistance is heavy!
Really? I can only see three people at the base, man. I mean, I literally flattened everybody else out. They're all flat red at this point. So yeah, sometimes the enemy AI can get...
King 6, we have eyes on the target. One SA-2, one flat face.
Do you know? Interesting. Anyway, let's just go ahead and be a little cautious of these people here. They can be lethal when they want to, the AI AME in this game. Now, they are most likely inside these tents here. So, most likely inside these tents because I did not see anybody else outside. But at this point, we can just go ahead and...
Bravo, we see two patrols in the valley.
Take them off, please. And... you. So that was it, nothing
King
else.
King 6, this is Alpha. Target destroyed. Moving to extraction.
Roger. King 6. No, not Roger King 6. Yeah, so there are some people in here, and I'm just going to leave them alone. Hopefully I won't die.
This is Charlie. We have a shooter in the North Tower.
Ouch, I accidentally zoomed in. I guess we won't get the kill stats anyway. It should be around 30 or 40 people. But anyway, let's just go ahead and end this mission here. Zero kills, of course. Maybe attach like a 3 or a 4 in front, because I feel like that's how many people I've killed thus far in this mission. But yeah, it turns out, I mean, just going full on assault is literally the best option in this game. The complete destruction of both objectives is an important victory for our operations. The elimination of the IMT's missile launch capability is a major step towards achieving safety and security of the entire region. Although no indication of the location of the stolen CDC materials was located, information regarding the location of another IMT base near the city of Kandavangan was found. I hope that is how you pronounce that name. I'm just making a hazard here. I'm just hazarding, I guess, here, making a hazard. Huh. So I'm guessing that mission will be unlocked after we, you know, complete these missions, and that will probably be the 6th mission, or hopefully a 7th, who knows, the Indonesia campaign might be longer. So yeah, apologies for the mix-up earlier, and Javelin is indeed the 3rd mission. Not exactly the 3rd mission, the missions in this Indonesia campaign aren't exactly following a sequence, because apart from a very loose sequence, because you see, the information from Jumpstart actually led us to a base where this Javelin was, like Operation Javelin, and the information from Spectre sort of led us to two new operations, one being Safe Passage, the other being Blackjack. I think the next time we come around, I will... That looks like a very difficult mission indeed. I will probably attempt Safe Passage, I don't know whether I will be able to finish it or not. Because escorting in this mission, that's difficult. Locate and defuse a terrorist bomb. What? Defuse? How am I gonna defuse a bomb? I don't even have a bomb defusal kit. This isn't CSGO, this is Delta Force. And you have to locate it on the entire map? That sounds difficult. But anyway, so this mission has the potential of, you know, going as planned. However, our allies are incompetent. I mean, I don't know how or why they're even in the Delta Force, because like easily a single militia, like easily like a single militant can completely total them, wreck them, like kill them outright. You know, it's like a no contest, right? They're like, one militant can easily flatten two Delta Force operatives. And that is usually what happens when Alpha or Charlie team are, you know, involved. So, if you want your teammate's life, you just need to storm the fortress all alone. And sometimes it gets difficult. At other times, well, the thing is, unless and until you take out most of the enemies, things will get dicey anyway, because as soon as you hit the objective, you will either get spotted or, the enemy will know that you're there and they'll turn their entire attention towards you, making you an easy target. So, yeah, you need to be a little proactive in, you know, taking charge of the situation, not sticking to the plan, and, you know, just killing everybody that you see on the map. Because if you don't do that, then, if you try to play tactically, if you try to play a little stealthy, then this game doesn't always support that, because, one, your allies easily die, second, you get spotted way too easily in this game. So, yeah, things just keep going sideways all the time, which is, like, quite unlike how things should be for Delta Force operative. But anyhow, I digress. Thank you for tuning in today. The next time we come back, we will be targeting Sea Passage. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.